In order to evaluate these expressions with rational exponents, we're going to write them in radical form and then simplify. To do this, we need to recognize that the base is going to tell us the radicand, or the number underneath the radical. The denominator of the rational exponent will tell us the index of the radical. And the numerator of the rational exponent will tell us the exponent, which can be inside the radical or outside the radical. So for 9 raised to the power of 1/2, the denominator of 2 tells us we'll have a square root. Normally with a square root, we don't put the index of 2, but we can. The radicand of the number underneath the radical is going to be 9. And the exponent on 9 is going to be 1. And of course, if the exponent is 1, we can leave it off. So this simplifies to the square root of 9, which is equal to 3. Next, we have 27 raised to the 2/3 power. Since the exponent has a denominator of 3, we know in radical form this will be a cube root. The radicand will be 27. Then because the numerator of the exponent is 2, we can either square 27 or square this cube root. And since 27 is a perfect cube, we'll go ahead and raise this to the second power. Again, since 27 is a perfect cube, it's equal to 3 times 3 times 3, or 3 cubed. The cube root of 27 is equal to 3, but this is being squared, and 3 squared is equal to 9. Now these next two we need to be a little more careful. We have negative 4 raised to the 1/2 power. Remember, the exponent is only attached to the base of 4, so it might be easier to think of this as the opposite of 4 raised to the 1/2 power. So in radical form, again, because the denominator is 2, we're going to have a square root, but in this case it's going to be the opposite, or a negative square root. The radicand is 4, and again, because the numerator of the fractional exponent is 1, this would be 4 raised to the first power, so the exponent of 1 is optional. So this is the opposite of the square root of 4, or negative square root of 4, which is equal to negative 2. And for our last example, we need to rewrite this with a positive exponent. To do this, we can think of this as a fraction with a denominator of 1, and if we move the base to the denominator, it will change the sign of the exponent. So this is equal to 1 over 16 raised to the power of positive 3/2. So now we can convert this to radical form. We would have 1 over, again, the denominator of the fractional exponent is 2, so we have a square root. Again, for a square root, the index is 2, but we normally don't include it. Our radicand is 16. And then since the numerator of the fractional exponent is 3, we can either cube 16 or cube the square root. Again, since 16 is a perfect square, we'll cube the square root. And since the square root of 16 is equal to 4, this would be 1 over 4 raised to the third, or 1 over 4 times 4 times 4 is equal to 64. So we have 1/64. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.